not.
Keep your filthy hands off me! I don't need your help to walk SS pig!
No, not SS. Wehrmacht. Unterfeld Wehrbeschutz. Wehrmacht. German army. Not the SS.
1, 2, 3, 4. Chin, stomach, right cross, left cross, both to the head. And believe me, when Rosenfeld gets mad, it hurts.
So what happened?
He fell and he didn't move.
So you won the match?
No, not quite. A big silence. They left it there. But at nighttime they came for me, a dozen or so. They broke my wrists with iron bars. The guy I knocked out joined them and started on me again. An SS officer came in screaming at them to stop. I'd been selected for a special project. They patched me up and brought me here. I don't even know why.
We're to be liberated. Liberated.
With a safe conduct pass to neutral Switzerland.
There. It's clear enough now.
What's this story?
Passes to Switzerland. That's wonderful. I can get treatment there.
And our wives and children will also be released. They'll join us.
Your wives, your children, please.
It's sure. We're to be released within the hour with immediate departure to Switzerland. Once we've signed.
Signed what?
Nothing important. A simple statement.
The usual stupidities of the Nazis.
What statement?
We're supposed to recognize... Wait. Here. We, the elite of the Jewish people, recognize in writing and unanimously the ideological and spiritual superiority of National Socialism over Judaism and its derivatives, and that the German people constitute the superior race and the people to lead to humanity towards its ultimate destiny.
The physical extermination of Jews is no longer enough. They now want a spiritual capitulation.
So what? They're not so very wrong after all.
Him again.
Deutschland über alles.
That will do, Valor. You can turn off that crap right now.
Intolerable.
I left everything, my country and my family, to help the German Jews.
Precisely. We're all German Jews here, so help us.
But we have a historic responsibility, collectively as Jews, to stand up to the Nazis.
Cut the blah blah. We don't need it. We communists know how to adapt our tactics to strategic objectives. The end justifies the means. What's it to you to sign a worthless piece of paper? You're a fanatic. You calmly put your ideology above the lives of men, women, and children, all German Jews. What is your real mission? You just said it yourself. And it's an ideological perversion. Be warned, Levy, there may be other ways to solve the question.
And just what might those be?
Mr. Cohn, calm down. Dr. Levy, you do admit that it's your religious and Zionist ideology that makes you refuse to sign, rather than your mistrust of the Nazis' offer?
For both, Professor Stryver, one is for me as obvious as the other.
All stand! I am SS Albersturmführer. The German Reich has given you a very important task. We await the end of your deliberations. You have now 41 minutes. Once you have signed the official declaration unanimously, you'll be transported to the Swiss border where your passage has been arranged. But it's the poet, Adolf Kessler. I recognize him. I didn't know he was a Jew. Mr. Kessler, I'm sorry to find you here. I'm one of your biggest admirers.
Thus push to new shores. In the eternal night, washed away without return, can we never upon the ocean of the ages drop anchor a single day? O time, suspend your flight, and you, propitious hours, suspend your course.
Zev Levy, I have to tell you something.
I'm listening.
I'm concerned for you.
What are your concerns?
You are a Zionist Jew.
Yes.
You are the chief delegate of the Haganah in Germany.
So?
I do not think the Nazis will agree to release a man of your importance. You will certainly be sent to Auschwitz.
Rudy Cohn, I have to tell you something.
I'm listening.
I'm concerned for you.
What are your concerns?
You're a communist Jew.
Yes.
You are head of the underground communist party in Germany.
So?
I do not think the Nazis will agree to release a man of your importance. I say to you all, personalities such as yourselves will never be released by the Nazis. Once you sign their declaration, you will be at best returned to Auschwitz.
At best? And the worst?
Worse than Auschwitz?
What will be for you, who refuse to sign?
I have no doubts, no illusions. I'll be immediately executed.
The Theodor Herzl wanted to organize the first Zionist Congress in Munich, but we, the German Jews, oppose him because we are Germans first and Jews only after that. We live in harmony here, Jews and Christians. It's people like you who brought back anti-Semitism. Mark my words, I am German, a German patriot. I support our democratically elected government, and I'm not afraid to say I support the Nazi Party.
How very sad.
I can't take it anymore, and I'm not the only one. Millions of Jews have given it up over the centuries, converted, assimilated, melted into the mass. What do you expect? It's too hard to be a Jew.
Ishung exelgerat las. Ishung exelgerat las seine Welt. Die ganze Welt des Schmerzen muss es tragen. Die ganze Welt muss es tragen.
Bravo!
The poem expresses some favorite themes of Heine's. The knowledge of suffering, the pain of absence.
I feel as if I'm dreaming.
You're not alone.
Why?
I don't understand.
What do you not understand? What do you not understand? You think because you're Jewish, you have a monopoly on intelligence and sensitivity?
No, of course not. It's just that as you are an SS.
Anyway, you are a very talented musician. Surely you'll be famous. What is your civilian name?
It's true that my name began to circulate. Wasser, Karl.
Wasser, Karl? It's funny.
Why?
Your initials, WC, water closets, toilets. Not very musical, like your voice. No surprise, though, when I see what you did to your old teacher.
This is an insult. An insult! The SS is insulted by this Jew!
I was secure!
Stand back! Nobody move! Schultz! Keep them covered! You insult the SS! You insult Germany! Defend your
Insanity of German army!
Back off! Back off!
Hacker! Are you deaf or insubordinate?
SS Obersturmführer, when you address a superior, you should mention his rank. You want to know who is Hacker? Hauptmann, Ernst Hacker, Wehrmacht, war wounded 1918, awarded the Blaue Max.
Hauptmann Ernst Hacker? You pretend to hold the Blaue Max, the German Reich's highest decoration, just like Hermann Göring?
I do not need to confirm my own statements. Do not insult me.
During the war in 17, when they came out of the trenches to attack the French, nearly all of my father's platoon were killed. My father called for help. Bullets whistled all around him. To save him would have been suicide. An officer ran to him and carried him on his back into the trench. That officer was Hauptmann Ernst Hager. Yes, Herr Hauptmann, I come from Schwabach. I'm the son of Klaus Schulz.
Israel will be reborn. I do not sign.
Look, we are living a nightmare. These gentlemen are standing around in quiet discussion, exchanging lofty ideas. Soon we will perhaps order a glass of tea with cookies. Wake up! The Nazis expect a declaration and then we'll leave for Switzerland as Weiler did. That's the equation. Everybody agrees to sign except one, and it must be unanimous. So the solution to the equation is very simple. Zev Levy will not sign and thereby condemns us all to die. We must therefore condemn him to die. We must eliminate this fanatic in order to achieve unanimity.
You're out of your mind. Do we look like criminals?
Your equation is unacceptable and intolerable.
Wait. I want to try a compromise.
Ah, he becomes reasonable. You said with a little pressure.
On one condition. You like equations. I wonder if you're a good mathematician.
Are you joking? I'm a university professor of mathematics, not to mention quantum physics.
And you were nominated for a prize?
For a prize? For the prize. The Nobel Prize in Mathematics. Yes, sir.
For which research?
I achieved the dream of all mathematicians. I squared the circle.
Explain how you did this, Hans.
Too complicated for you. I can explain this only to physicists at the highest level. For you, I will simplify by saying only that I calculated the projection of a square in space-time. My friend Einstein had showed that space-time was curved. I showed that in space-time, a square becomes a circle. Hundreds of pages of calculation and years of work.
It's Greek to me, but it seems amazing.
Quite remarkable.
Outside of psychoanalysis, I'm totally incompetent in the sciences.
Imposter, crook.
I'm
Beg your pardon?
You are an imposter for a simple reason. Because the Nobel Prize in Mathematics does not exist. Nobel did not create a mathematics prize. The world's highest distinction in mathematics is the Fields Medal, not the Nobel Prize.
The Fields Medal, it was a slip at the time, like the Fields Medal. I meant the Fields Medal, a slip, Dr. Levy, a simple slip of the tongue. Well played, Dr. Levy. All right, I'm not a professor, I'm not even a mathematician. I'm a simple Polish Jew, naturalized German. I worked in cheese.
What is Judaism? You do know, don't you? Yaakov Bear, you are the person we need. We'd like to ask you a few questions. Please try to understand.
Look to yourselves. This meeting was called by someone much greater than we are. We must have something here important to say or do.
And that man standing there, do you know who he is?
That man, his presence is also required. I don't know why, but he must also have a task.
Professor Bear, will you allow us to join you at the table?
I've been waiting for you for nearly an hour.
I'm an atheist, but I'm ready to listen to what a man like you will tell me.
There are no atheists in a foxhole. It's time to learn to pray.
A question, Yaakov. How long does it take to understand something in Judaism?
10 seconds. For a full understanding, a lifetime.
Let's start with the 10-second version.
Voila.
What's that?
Remember what Issachar Weiler said. We do not ask you to believe, we ask you to act. What is after death, we don't know. But we do know how to change this world. The tefillin, the boxes with extracts from the Torah. One must be attached to the arm, the other to the head. Pray, study, act in this world. That's Judaism.
Backs are against the wall. The enemy is in our face. Well, so it's from him. We must ask liberation. He has all the power.
Who do you mean by him?
Him.
Him, the master of the universe. A moment ago, God prayed with us. The 10th man. So God is here with us.
So?
So, I say God is here with us, and you say so. God is somewhere in this room, and we sit around calmly. So, we begin by offering him a chair. You are now all turned to face the chair. You are now all facing the master of the universe, and you will now all speak to him. And Ernst, you will speak first.
From the time of Hitler's rise, I should have gone to the land of Israel. I would have fought for the Jewish people. I'm sorry. That's all I have to say to him.
I'm a psychoanalyst. I treated my patients as best I could. If I've acquired any merit, then I ask him to save you, all of you. For myself? No. I've seen too much.
It's not. The Mishnah teaches us that to save one man or one woman is equivalent to saving all of humanity.
If I was sure that God was sitting in this chair, I would put him on trial. I would drag him into court and I would charge him. And I'd be a ruthless prosecutor.
Soviet trial conducted by a Stalinist. God has no chance of escape.
So it's for you to speak, Hannah. Judaism, the Bible, one word.
Hannah.
Bible is ovens, a concern for others. Civilization begins when the other is recognized.
Before you, I raise a solemn protest. Before the master of the universe. I'm going to die by the hand of the Germans who call themselves Christians. We gave the Christians the Bible, the prophets, Jesus, the apostles. They should be grateful, should respect us. The response, accusations, persecutions, tortures, inquisition, forced conversion, insults, murders, pogroms. Their church has demonized us for nearly 2,000 years. The Pope is silent before hundreds of thousands, maybe millions of dead Jews, children.
Master of the universe, I'll be brief, I'll be direct, I'll get right to it. I'm asking you a question. What are you playing at? How long will this game go on? You ask us to make your name known in all the earth. You promised us heaven and earth, and we believed it. We've worked for it, we've prayed for it, we've been dying for 4,000 years for it. Because of us, billions of men and women know you. The result? Auschwitz. Is that our reward? So I, Hans Meyer, cheese merchant, will talk to you like no one has ever spoken. Stop it now. Give us our freedom. Give us back our promised land. Replant our trees. Rebuild our cities. Replant our forests. And if not, we'll drop you. Because we'll have nothing to do with the God who persecutes us.
I ask if you are ready. Is the declaration signed? I call Hans Meyer.
Why is it me every time? Start with someone else.
Hans Meyer.
Now, just as Sir Isaac Newton discovered gravity when an apple fell from the tree, so did I discover squaring of the circle when a fine round camembert turned into a perfectly square pont l'evêque cheese.
Hans Meyer, the statement.
Right away. I've never been a hero.
We love you, Hans.
Thank you for everything, Hans.
First, I've got a personal statement, nothing to do with my colleagues here, and then I'll read the official declaration.
Go ahead.
I, Hans Meyer, master cheesemaker from a centennial institution founded in 1837, a house whose reputation I've extended. You know, they came to see me. It was hard work, because I, Hans Meyer...
Your statement.